you're like most marketers, you're constantly juggling multiple tactics and assets at the same time. With the campaigns feature inside of HubSpot, you can group those assets together and see how they're performing as a whole.
Welcome to HubSpot Hacks, where we help you get more out of HubSpot.
Creating campaigns in HubSpot is a great way to stay organized and to draw more insight out of the data. And the best news is that they're really easy to create. So let's jump in here. To get to the campaigns tool, you're gonna go to marketing and planning and strategy and then campaigns. All right, so once you're in this campaigns view, you're gonna click this create campaign button and give it a name. It's important that you like the name that you give it because you can't change it later. So we'll just call it HubSpot Hacks. All right, so you don't have to do any of the following steps in any particular order, but this is the order that I like to do it, and I think it's a helpful way to think about it. So the first thing I do is go to actions and edit details, and enter the budget for the campaign. So I'll just say 1,000, and any notes you have for the campaign that you want your team to be able to see or that you want to be able to see later, you can enter there and hit save. And then I like to add my goals. So the nice thing about goals is you can see you've got these metrics on your campaign window right down here. When you add the goals, they'll actually show the goal underneath each metric. So I'll show you what I'm talking about here. Go to actions and then edit goals. You don't have to fill all of these out if you've got a particular goal, but if you do have goals for all the metrics, you can. So let's say we just wanna get to 1,000 sessions and we wanna close 2 deals out of that. So hit save. And you can see that now we have that goal for sessions underneath there and the goal for deals underneath the closed deals. So the next thing that you can do is actually add assets to this campaign. So like I said earlier, campaigns are a great way to kind of keep all of your tactics and assets organized. So to do that, you can click this Add Assets button. And what this allows you to do is add any assets that you've already created inside of HubSpot. So you're gonna see this list on the left of all the different types of assets available. So you've got blog posts, social posts. Remember, we're in our test portal, so there's not a whole lot in here, but in your portal, there's probably quite a bit. You can always select from this list, or you can search if you're looking for something in particular. And if you're creating any assets, once this campaign is already created, there's almost always gonna be a drop-down box whenever you create that asset. So if you create a new blog post, it's in settings, for example, where you can select this campaign. So you don't have to have all the assets created before you create the campaign, kind of up to you what order you wanna do that in. So let's say we're gonna add the sample blog post and this learn more call to action and these 2 web pages. So I'm gonna add those and hit save. And now we have that added. So you can see that we've got 1 blog post here, 2 calls or 1 call to action and 2 web pages. And if you expand those, you can see what those assets actually are. The other thing that you can do is maybe you want to track something that isn't necessarily related to an asset inside of HubSpot. HubSpot allows you to create a tracking URL. So let's say you wanted to put this on an ad you put somewhere, or maybe a link that's going out through email, through somebody else's email list. Doesn't really matter. Any URL you wanna track, you can create that here. So you'd put the final destination of where you want that URL to go. You would put the campaign here, so it's gonna pre-populate with whatever campaign you were in when you click that button. You've got different options for search, so email marketing, paid search, social, etc. And then you can add more details here if you want. So once you create that and have all of those filled, it'll allow you to click these create buttons and then add it to the campaign. I'm gonna talk for just a second about these metrics here because sometimes these are confusing to people. So sessions, just like it sounds, just website sessions. You can also hover over any of these to get a little bit more detail. The 2 ways that HubSpot really tracks metrics for campaigns is first touch or last touch, and you can change that at any time with this drop down right here. But first touch basically means that it's going to be tracked if the first thing that a contact interacts with inside an asset or web page if it's associated with this campaign, then that contact is going to be associated with this campaign right here under this new contacts first touch. So let's say you write a blog post associated with this campaign, they find that blog post through Google, and then from there they go to a landing page to become a contact, or they fill out a form to become a contact. That would track as a first touch contact for this campaign. Influence contacts are going to be any contacts that interacted with anything that you're tracking with this campaign, any asset, any tracking URL, regardless of what they touched first or last when they were created. So these are all the influence contacts. Because of this, you want to be kind of careful about what you track in a campaign. So for example, I've seen some people track emails they send to a huge list. Well, if you send that to a huge list and that email is associated with this campaign, it's going to mark all of those contacts that open that email as influence contacts for this campaign. So you want to be kind of careful about what you track, and really kind of matters what story you're trying to tell with this data. Closed deals are going to be any deals that closed by contacts that were influenced by this campaign. And so you might have a deal show up in multiple campaigns if a contact was influenced by multiple campaigns. So maybe they interacted with a blog post associated with this campaign, and they also interacted with a landing page associated with a different campaign. They close a deal, that deal is going to be tagged to both of those campaigns. Then the influence revenue is just any of the revenue that is listed under the closed deals. So hopefully that makes a little bit more sense. But that really is all there is to it for campaigns. One of the things that you can do that's not super intuitive, once there are contacts kind of shown up in here, you can click on them and it'll pop up a list of all the contacts here. If you want to create a list that you can do things with, like send emails to or something like that, of all of the contacts who were influenced or who were first touched by a campaign, we do also have a video for that. So you can check that out as well. But if there's any questions you have about this video or you want to see us cover something else in a future hack, go ahead and drop it in those comments below. And as always, make sure you hit that subscribe button for more HubSpot hacks, tips, and how-tos.